G'day, I'm Thomas and I'm 15.
I'm Remy and I'm 15.
And I'm Francesca and I'm 15.
And this is our SpaceLab entry. During space flights of long duration, microgravity takes its toll on the human body. Space flights of such nature can cause adverse health effects, such as muscle wastage, chronic fatigue, insomnia caused by environmental stress, and neurosis.
In Asia and now Northern American countries grows a special mushroom known as the Reishi mushroom. The chemical composition of the ganodermic acid contained in this particular mushroom is similar to that of steroid hormones, something that may possibly positively influence muscular toning of astronauts in microgravity or zero-g environments on future long-duration missions. So knowing the manner in which the fungi grows in such environments could prove essential in solving the problems faced on these sort of trips. It could also provide a solution on long journeys where it would be impractical to bring certain things aboard due to weight constraints as a source of medication.
In the 1G environment present on Earth, the positioning of the hymenium, or fruiting body, of the Reishi mushroom is said to be negatively geotrophic, meaning that the hymenium will face opposite to the origin of the gravity, or right side up.
We therefore pose the question, how does microgravity affect the positioning of the hymenia, or fruiting body, in the Ganoderma Lucidum fungi, or the Reishi mushroom?
And to give us the answers to this question, we will be testing the hypothesis when in the microgravity environment, the Ganoderma Lucidum hymenia will position itself in no predictable orientation with the stape, or the stem, growing in an unsystematic fashion compared to that of the fungi on Earth.
To test this, we intend to grow multiple spores on fixed pieces in the same orientation of decaying Eastern Hemlock wood, or Tsuga canadensis, which is a natural growth medium for this specific fungi, in a human environment. To determine if the growth patterns of this fungus are in fact unsystematic in microgravity, still pictures can be sequentially captured to observe the development patterns of this fungus.
We came to the conclusion that habitat 1, or the butterfly habitat, would be the most suitable for the experiment that we would like to take out due to the necessity of humidity and environmental control and monitoring. We predict that the fungi will in fact grow in an unsystematic manner with no predictable orientation due to the absence of gravity.